Don't ask me what you know is true. Don't have to tell you I love your precious heart. I was standing, you were there. Two worlds colliding, and we could never tear us apart.
Voting for Dukakis.
Hmm. Well, maybe when you have children of your own who need braces, you can't afford them because half of your husband's paycheck goes to the federal government, you'll regret that.
My husband's paycheck?
Oh. Anyway, I'm not gonna squeeze one out till I'm like 30.
Will you still be working at the Yarn Barn? Because I hear that's a really great place to raise children.
That's really funny.
No, I think a year of partying's enough. She'll be going to Harvard next fall.
I haven't even gotten in yet.
Do you honestly think Michael Dukakis will provide for this country till you're ready to squeeze one out?
Yeah, I do.
When can I squeeze one out?
Not until 8th grade.
Excuse me.
Donnie, you're such a dick.
Whoa, Elizabeth. A little hostile there. Maybe you should be the one in therapy. Then Mom and Dad can pay someone $200 an hour to listen to all your thoughts. So we don't have to.
Okay. You want to tell Mom and Dad why you stopped taking your medication?
You're such a fuck-ass.
Please.
Did you just call me a fuck-ass?
Elizabeth, that's enough.
You can go suck a fuck.
Oh, please tell me, Elizabeth, how exactly does one suck a fuck?
You want me to tell you?
Please tell me.
We will not have this at the dinner table. Stop.
Fuck-ass.
Part of the reason that I took a year off was to be with you.
What? How did you know?
I didn't know it was such a big deal.
It is a big deal.
I'm reading.
Get out of my room.
Where do you go at night?
You just get out of my room.
Did you toilet paper the Johnson's house?
Is that what you came in here to ask me?
No.
I stopped rolling houses in the sixth grade, Mom.
What happened to my son? I don't recognize this person today.
Then why don't you start taking the goddamn pills? Bitch.
Her son just called me a bitch.
You're not a bitch. You're bitching. But you're not a bitch. I want to be a president of the United States who makes sure that we never again do business with a drug-running Panamanian dictator, that we never again funnel aid to the Contras who convicted drug dealers. Values begin at the top. Those are the values I want to bring to the presidency and to the White House beginning in January of 1989. Panama is a friendly country. I went down there and talked to the president of Panama about cleaning up their money laundering. Mr. Noriega was there, but there was no evidence at that time. And when the evidence was there, we indicted him.
I've been watching you.
Thank you.
closer. Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds. That is when the world will end.
Son? Donnie Darko? What the heck's going on here?
Who is it, Don?
It's Eddie Darko's kid. I'm sorry about this, Jim. He's just a neighborhood kid. He just...
Guess he was sleep golfing?
Watch out for that drool spot.
Are you all right, son?
So, let's snap the links at night, okay?
I'm sorry, Dr. Brazier. You don't have any room.
Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. I'm with the FAA.
The what?
I'm with the FAA. If you don't mind, we'd like to speak to you and your husband privately.
Private?
Please.
Come on, we're going to hotel.
They don't know where it came from.
They don't know, Samantha.
Is there any way we can make money from this? Can we get on television if we see the airline?
Shut up, Sam.
Why do I have to sleep with Donnie? He stinks.
When you fall asleep tonight, I'm gonna fart in your face.
I'm telling your mom.
Samantha, don't go over there.
Frankie Fiedler. You remember. From high school. He died. Remember? On his way to the prom. They said he was doomed. Saying the same thing about Donnie. Or Donnie. But he dodged it. He dodged his bullet. Somebody was watching over him.
Mrs. Farmer will bring you home after practice. Donnie, bye, honey. Donnie. Good luck.
Oh, my God. Okay, tell me everything.
Not allowed to talk about it.
My God. Hi, Sharita.
Shut up.
Darko, Jake's dead. Huh?
You're like a celebrity, man. I've been like calling you like a jillion times. Where you been?
We stayed at a hotel.
Hey, my dad said he saw you at the golf course. You sleepwalking again, that buddy?
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, now that you're famous, you gotta have a smoke.
What happens if you tell Mom and Dad about this, Sam?
They'll put Ariel in the garbage disposal.
God damn right I would.
So rowdy.
Hey, Sharita. You want a cigarette?
Shut up! Shut up!
Go back to China, bitch.
Just leave her alone.
Some good shit, huh?
It's a fucking cigarette.
Would hear with respect of how old Misery's house had been destroyed. It was as though this plan had been with him all his life, pondered through the seasons. Now, in his 15th year, crystallized with the pain of puberty. What is Graham Greene trying to communicate with this passage? Why did the children break into old Misery's house? Joni?
They wanted to rob him.
Joni, if you had actually read the short story, which had a whopping 13 pages, would have kept you up all night, you would know that the children find a great deal of money in the mattress, but they burn it. Donnie Darko, Perhaps with your recent brush with mass destruction, you can give us your opinion.
Well, they see it right when they flood the house and they tear it to shreds that, like, destruction is a form of creation, so the fact that they burn the money is ironic. They just want to see what happens when they tear the world apart. I don't want to change things.
May we help you?
Yeah, I just registered and they put me in the wrong English class.
You look like you belong here.
Where do I sit?
Sit next to the boy you think is the cutest. Oh. Quiet!
Oh my God.
Better choose. Joni, get up.
Well, construction guys say it'll take about a week to fix the roof. Damn, Daryl, I better not fuck us on the shingle bridge.
You still don't know?
No what?
We're a team.
Oh, no. Apparently they can't tell us what happened. Yeah, something about a matching serial number that got burned. I had to sign a form saying I wouldn't talk to him.
So we're not supposed to tell anyone what nobody knows.
Yes. But you don't mind. What's your doctor's name?
Dr. Thurman, Dad.
Yes. You tell Dr. Thurman whatever you want.
Dad.
What?
Dad!
What's that woman doing standing out in the middle of the damn road?
Today, maybe tomorrow.
Well, what'd she say to you? Friend.
Real or imaginary?
Imaginary.
Would you like to talk about this friend?
Frank.
Frank. What did Frank say?
He said to follow him.
Follow him? Where?
Into the future.
And then what happens?
I And then he said that the world is coming to an end.
Do you think the world is coming to an end?
No. That's stupid.
For my entire life, I was a victim of my own fear.
Love.
I was feeding fear. Food.
Fear.
And finally, I looked in the mirror. Not just in the mirror. I looked through the mirror. And in that image, I saw my ego reflection. For 2 years, I thought it was normal for a 10-year-old to wet the bed. We tried everything. The solution was there all the time. I'm not afraid anymore.
All over America, people have come together to join hands. People who believe that human life is absolutely too important, too valuable, and too precious. Be controlled by fear.
Pay close attention. You could miss something.
Hello. My name is Jim Cunningham, and welcome to Controlling Fear.
Into a world of strange and beautiful magic. Wow.
Donnie! The Last Unicorn by Samantha Darko.
There was once a unicorn named Ariel.
It's not wrinkles, Dave. It's just, lining the bunkers.
It's almost 7:45. The bus should have been here like 20 minutes ago.
Maybe Martha Moo finally went nuts and hijacked the bus.
Hey, you know, there's like this rule. At 7:45, we get to go home.
There's no rule.
Charita. You should go home. Yeah. Yeah, if you're still here and the bus comes, we're all gonna get in trouble.
Shut up.
Yeah, Dad.
Hey, Porky Pig. I hope you get molested.
Mama said the school is closed today because it's flooded.
No way.
Yeah.
Holy shit, that's the best news I've ever heard.
Hey,
My God, is this ever going to stop?
Eventually, yes, it will. But right now, I got 12 classrooms full of water. All coming from a busted water main.
What else?
What else? Principal Cole, I'll show you what else.
How did this happen?
I heard a cat burglar broke in and trashed everything. And the mongrel got his head cut off. True. Beth's mom said the boys' locker room was flooded and they found feces everywhere.
What are feces?
Baby mice.
I like your boobs.
Hey. School's canceled.
Do you want to walk me home?
Sure.
Don't look so
freaked. I'm not. You check your backpack. This guy's up to steal shit.
Yeah. Fuck him.
So, why'd you move here?
My parents got a divorce. My mom had to get a restraining order against my stepdad. He has emotional problems.
Oh, I have those too. What kind of emotional problems does your dad have?
He stabbed my mom 4 times in the chest.
Oh. Did he go to jail?
No, he fled. They still can't find him. But my mom and I had to change our names. And I thought Gretchen Ross was really cool.
Yeah, I was in jail once. I mean, I accidentally burned down this house and it was abandoned, but still. You know, got held back in school. Can't drive till I'm 21, you know. But I'm over all that. I'm painting and stuff. Writing. I want to be a writer. Maybe a painter. I don't know. Maybe both. I'll write a book and draw the pictures. Then maybe people understand. Change things.
Donnie Darko. What the hell kind of name is that? It's like some sort of superhero or something.
What makes you think I'm not?
Look, I should go. For physics, Montanoff is having me write this essay. Greatest invention ever to benefit mankind.
It's Molotov, but that's easy. Antiseptics. Like the whole sanitation thing, Joseph Lister, 1895. Before antiseptics, there was no sanitation, especially in medicine.
You mean soap?
I'm really glad school is flooded today.
Why is that?
Because you and I never had this conversation.
You're weird.
Sorry.
No, that was a compliment.
Well, look, you want to go with me?
Where do you want to go?
I mean, like, go with me, you know, like, that's what we call it here. Going together.
Sure.
Okay, hey, where are you going?
I'm going home.
I'd like to try something new this time. Have you ever been hypnotized?
No.
And when I clap my hands twice, you will wake up. Do you understand?
Yes.
So, tell me about your week.
I met a girl.
What is her name?
Gretchen. We're going together now.
Do you still think about girls a lot?
Yeah.
How are things going at school?
I think about girls a lot.
I asked you about school, Donnie.
I think about fucking a lot during school.
What else do you think about during school?
Married with children.
You think about your family?
I just turned down the volume and think about fucking Christina Applegate.
I asked you about your family, Donnie.
No. I don't think about fucking my family. That's gross.
I'd like to hear about your friend Frank.
Hey, you fuck. Did you tell him that I flooded the school?
I didn't say shit.
Yeah, well, that's not what I heard. You think I did it?
Yeah, well, if you're innocent, then you have nothing to worry about, right?
You know what I think?
I think you did it.
Thank you.
Casey. That's all I need.
So we gotta find ourselves a Smurfette.
Smurfette?
Mm-hmm. Not some, like, tight-ass middle-sex chick, you know? Like this cute little blonde that'll get down and dirty with the guys. Like Smurfette does.
Smurfette doesn't fuck.
That's bullshit. Smurfette fucks all the other Smurfs. Why do you think Papa Smurf made her? Because all the other Smurfs were getting too horny.
No, not Vanity. I heard he was a homosexual.
Okay, well, you know what? Then she fucks them while Vanity watches, okay?
Well, what about Papa Smurf? I mean, he must get into the action.
Yeah, what he does, he films the gangbang. Later on, he beats off to the tape.
First of all, Papa Smurf didn't create Smurfette. Gargamel did. She was sent in as Gargamel's evil spy with the intention of destroying the Smurf village. But the overwhelming goodness of the Smurf way of life transformed her. And as for the whole gangbang scenario, it just couldn't happen. Smurfs are asexual. They don't even have reproductive organs under those little white pants. This was so illogical, you know, about being a Smurf. You know, what's the point of living if you don't have a dick?
Damn it, Donnie. Why do you gotta get so smart on us?
Grandma Death.
I hate that Miss Farmer. She's such a fucking bitch.
Yeah.
How old is Grandma Death?
101. She does the same thing every day. Just walks back and forth and back and forth the mailbox. Nothing ever in there.
Oh, wait. She goes. She's going back to the box. We may still have mail.
Mail.
Here it is.
And
this could be it.
Oh,
no dice, no. Grandma.
No, sorry. Sorry.
Someone ought to write that bitch.
Authorities continued their search today for a suspect in the Middlesex Ridge School vandalism. The private school has asked for public donations to help restore its beloved mascot, known only as the Mop. In other news...
trying to accomplish here.
There was urine and feces flooded in my office.
My office.
In cooperation with the county police, we have begun an active investigation into the cause of the flooding. And our suspects include several of our own students.
Now, I want to know why this filth is being taught to our children.
Kitty, I would appreciate if you would wait.
Dr. Cole. Not only am I a teacher, but I am also a parent of a Middlesex child. Therefore, I am the only person here who transcends the parent-teacher bridge.
Don't worry. You got away with it.
I have in my hand Graham Greene's The Destructors. This short story is part of my daughter's English assignment. In this story, several children destroy an elderly man's house from inside out.
How can you do that?
And how do they do this? They flood the house by breaking through a water main.
I can do anything I want. So can you.
The PTA doesn't ban books. The PTA is here to acknowledge that pornography is being taught in our curriculum.
It's meant to be ironic.
Excuse me, you need to go back to grad school.
Why do you make me for the school?
Know who Graham Greene is.
I think we have all seen Bonanza.
Well, while we are on other topics,
where did you come from?
Do you believe in time travel?
Who are you talking to?
I'm just taking my pills, Sam. A storm is coming, Frank says. A storm that will swallow the children. And I will deliver them from the kingdom of pain. I'll deliver the children back to their doorsteps. I'll send the monsters back to the underground. I'll send them back to a place where no one else can see them. Except for me. Because I am Donnie Darko.
Who's Frank?
A 6 foot tall bunny rabbit.
In these modern times, our attitudinal beliefs are so delicate, so fragile.
I have had a cunning vision. This vision is a little mystery.
It's important that our lifeline be rejuvenated so that we can breathe again. It's time to breathe. It is time to breathe. Thank you, Jim Cunningham.
Thank you, Jim Cunningham.
So now let us begin lifeline exercise number one. Please press stop now.
As you can see, the lifeline is divided into two polar extremes, fear and love. Fear is in the negative energy spectrum,
And love is in the positive energy spectrum.
Duh.
Excuse me? No, duh is a product of fear. Now, on each card is a character dilemma, which applies to the lifeline. Please take this. Thank you. Please read each character dilemma aloud and place an X on the lifeline in the appropriate place. Sharita?
Juanita has an important math test today. She's known about the test for several weeks, but has not studied. In order to keep from failing her class, Juanita decided that she will cheat on the math test.
Good, good, very good. Mr. Darko.
Ling Ling finds a wallet on the ground filled with money. She takes the wallet to the address on the driver's license but keeps the money inside the wallet. I'm sorry, Ms. Farmer. I don't get this.
Just place an X on the lifeline in the appropriate place.
No, I know what to do. I just don't get this. You can't just lump things into two categories. Things aren't that simple.
The lifeline is divided that way.
Well, life isn't that simple. I mean, who cares if Ling Ling returns the wallet and keeps the money? It has nothing to do with either fear or love.
Fear and love are the deepest of human emotions.
Okay, but you're not listening to me. There are other things that need to be taken into account here, like the whole spectrum of human emotion. You can't just lump everything into these two categories and then just deny everything else.
If you don't complete the assignment, you'll get a zero for the day.
Donald, let me preface this by saying that your Iowa test scores are intimidating. So, let's go over this again. What exactly did you say to Ms. Farmer?
I'll tell you what he said. He asked me to forcibly insert the lifeline exercise card into my anus. Cares about responsibility, morality, family values.
Mm-hmm. Kitty, excuse us, please. They've suspended him from after-school activities for the next 6 months. Ever since this jet engine fiasco, I honestly don't know what's gotten into
it. Rose, I'll tell you this because our daughters have been on the dance team together for 2 years, and I respect you as a woman. But after witnessing your son's behavior this afternoon, I have significant doubts about your... Our paths through life must be righteous. I urge you to go home and look in the mirror and pray that your son doesn't succumb to the path of fear.
Wait, do you remember that
weird gym teacher, Mrs. Farmer? Yeah. Okay, well, my brother told her to shove a book up her ass today. And then my parents just bought him all this new shit. And I know, I wish a jet engine would fall in my room.
Sound kind of weird, but do you know anything about time travel?
Ah, wormhole with an Einstein-Rosen bridge, which is theoretically a wormhole in space controlled by man. So, according to Hawking, a wormhole may be able to provide a shortcut for jumping between two distant regions of space-time.
So in order to travel back in time, you have to have a big spaceship or something that can travel faster than the speed of light.
Theoretically.
And be able to find one of these wormholes.
The basic principles of time travel are there. You've got your vessel and your portal, and your vessel can be just about anything, most likely a spacecraft.
Like a DeLorean?
An aircraft of any kind.
You know, I love that movie, the way they shot it. It's so, like, futuristic, you know?
Listen, I don't want to tell anybody that I gave you this. The woman who wrote this used to teach here. She was a nun many years before that, but, and overnight she just, she became this entirely different person. She up and left the church. She wrote this book. She started teaching science right here at Benesex. The philosophy of time travel. Roberta Sparrow. That's right. Come on. Roberta Sparrow.
Called the philosophy of time travel.
What does philosophy have to do with time travel?
Who's there? Guess who wrote it?
Who? Roberta Sparrow. Huh. She wrote a book.
Grandma Death wrote a book.
That's a terrible nickname.
We almost hit her with the car the other day.
She lives up there in that piece of crap house, and you know she's loaded. She's...
Right. She used to be known for her gem collection. Kids used to go up there all the time and try to steal stuff from her. She became a total recluse. Well, I didn't even know she was alive till we damn near knocked her down the other.
She was just standing there in the middle of the road, frozen. So I got out of the car and I walked over to see if she was okay. And she leaned over and whispered in my ear.
What did she say?
I mean, I think Frank wants me to go talk to her, you know, because the last time I saw him, he asked me if I knew about time travel, and she wrote a book about it, so that can't be like a coincidence, right?
Donnie, what did Roberta Spiro say to you?
She said that every living creature on Earth has one.
How did that make you feel?
It reminded me of my dog, Callie. She died when I was 8, and she crawled underneath the porch.
To die.
To be alone.
Do you feel alone right now?
I mean, I'd like to believe I'm not, but I've just never seen any proof, so I just don't debate it anymore, you know? It's like I could spend my whole life debating it over and over again, weighing the pros and cons, and in the end, I still wouldn't have any proof, so I just don't debate it anymore. It's absurd.
The search for God is absurd.
It is if everyone dies alone.
Does that scare you?
I don't want to be alone.
And so his tapes have made me realize that for the last 39 years, I have been a prisoner of my own fear.
Fear.
Girls, you've got to meet this Jim Cunning man. I can't believe he's single.
And it has been a disappointing night indeed for these Super Bowl champions. You're right, Dad. Coach Joe Gibbs is on the sidelines, water dripping off his glasses, but he's got to be thinking, what happened? What went wrong tonight? And here's the kick.
Oh! No good. Shit. Need a quarterback. Mirror.
We need to go for a safety.
And so what the future holds for this Super Bowl MVP, we're just going to have to wait and see.
You guys want anything?
By the way, this week on a special Who's the Boss, starring Tony Danza and Judith Light, Samantha borrows Tony's van and gets caught without a license.
Well, we gotta make sure we don't miss that one, huh?
Here we are again. Work down now.
Thank you.
forget tomorrow we're meeting with our partners. The Young Inventors Fair.
Blood on your neck.
What are we going to invent?
What if you could go back in time and take all those hours of pain and darkness and replace them with something better?
Like images or what?
Yeah, like a Hawaiian sunset or the Grand Canyon. Just things that remind you of how beautiful the world is.
You know, we've been going together for like 2 weeks.
Yeah? You want to kiss me?
Well, I'm sorry.
I just want it to be a time when it...
When what?
When it reminds me just...
Reminds you how beautiful the world can be.
Yeah. And right now there's some fat guy over there staring at us.
I don't think telling any woman to forcibly insert an object up her anus is something that should go without consequence.
I think we can buy him an opiate.
I think we should get a divorce.
Tell Mom everything.
No, I don't. Let me see it.
No, it's not finished. It's
okay, it's cool. For seeing us at such late notice. We both felt that it was time for us to come in and discuss
what I think is going on with your son.
Yes. You know about his past, and he was suspended from school for insulting his gym teacher.
Well, I'm not really sure that's a good example, Rosa. I think he had just cause to insult her.
Rose, let me just lay out what I believe is happening here. Donnie's aggressive behavior, his increased detachment from reality, seemed to stem from his inability to cope with the forces in the world that he perceives to be threatening. Has he ever told you about his friend Frank?
Frank?
Yes, the giant bunny rabbit.
What?
I don't recall him ever having mentioned a rabbit.
Donnie is experiencing what is commonly called a daylight hallucination. This is a common occurrence among paranoid schizophrenics.
What can we do?
I would like to do more hypnotherapy and increase his medication.
Whatever will help him, really, is that's why we're here. We just would like him to experience some relief. So, if you think that more medication will do that, then I think we should give it a try.
It's like a force, you know, in your brain. It just sends you someplace.
Did you go someplace
for now? I know. I feel each time I keep waking up farther from my house.
Donnie Darko.
I know.
Good morning, you mongrels. Still sense some students out there who are actually afraid to say good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, that's what I like to hear. Because entirely too many young men and women today are completely paralyzed by their fears. They surrender their bodies to the temptation and destruction of drugs, alcohol, and premarital sex. Now, I'm going to tell you a little story today. It's a heartbreakingly sad story about a young man whose life was completely destroyed by these instruments of fear. A young man searching for love in all the wrong places. His name was Frank.
Through time.
What?
Hi, my stepsister, I'm sometimes worried that she eats too much.
Shut up, Kim.
I'm just trying to help you.
Oh, sweetheart, please. There's absolutely no reason to be embarrassed here. Many times we eat because we're afraid to face our ego reflection. All right? We find ourselves looking at the mirror rather than looking into and through the mirror. When we do that, we can finally see the reality of how beautiful we are.
please.
Sure.
Come on under. Don't be afraid.
How can I find out what I want to be when I grow up?
Oh, that's a hard one. Well, what I need you to do is look deep inside of yourself, deep within your heart, and find what it is in the world that makes you feel love. Pure, unconditional love. And go to that. In your studies, in your athletics, in your relationships, go towards love.
Thank you. Come on.
Next.
What do I do to learn how to fight?
What do I do to learn how to fight? Son, violence is a product of fear. Learn to truly love yourself. Truly love yourself. And the world will be yours.
Okay.
Get yourself up here. All right.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How much are they paying you to be here?
Excuse me? What is your name, son?
Gerald.
Well, Gerald, I think you're afraid.
Are you telling us this stuff so we can buy your book? Because I gotta tell you, if you are, that was some of the worst advice I ever heard.
You see how sad this is?
I want your sister to lose weight. Tell her to get off the couch, stop eating Twinkies, and maybe go after field hockey. You know what? No one ever knows what they want to be when they grow up. You know, it takes a little while to find that out, right, Jim? And you. Yeah, you. You're sick of some jerk shoving your head down the toilet, but you know what? Maybe you should lift some weights or take a karate lesson, and the next time he tries to do it, you kick him in the balls.
Son, do you see this? Right? This is an anger prisoner, a textbook.
He's not a prisoner.
Do you see the fear, people? This boy is scared to death of the truth. Son, it breaks my heart to say this, but I believe you are a very troubled and confused young man. I believe you are searching for the answers in all the wrong places.
You're right, actually. I am. I'm pretty troubled and I'm pretty confused, but I'm afraid, really, really afraid. Really afraid, but I think you're fucking Antichrist. It's amazing, you know? A man thinks he's telling the truth, and everything he says is just a fucking lie. Everything he says! Everyone thinks he's so rad. Shut. Everything he does, they just kind of...
Are you okay? Sit down. Calm down.
You ever hear of Grandma Death?
Who? Philosophy of time travel. What is this?
She wrote it. I've been seeing stuff. Like a lot of really messed up stuff. And there's chapters in that book that describe the stuff I've been seeing, and it can't just be a coincidence.
Oh.
gotta be in here somewhere. She never leaves this house.
Well, maybe she's asleep. Donnie, look.
Send her a letter.
Each vessel travels along a vector through space-time along its center of gravity.
Like a sphere.
I beg your pardon?
Like a spear that comes out of your chest.
Sure. Yeah. And in order for the vessel to travel through time, it's got to find a porthole, or in this case, a wormhole, or...
Well, could these portals just appear anywhere, anytime?
I think that's highly unlikely. No, I think what you're talking about is an act of God.
Well, if God controls time, then all time's predecided.
I'm not following.
Like, every living thing follows along a set path. And if you could see your path or channel, then you could see into the future, right? Like, that's a form of time travel.
Well, you're contradicting yourself, Donnie. If we were able to see our destinies manifest themselves visually, then we would be given a choice to betray our chosen destinies. And the mere fact that this choice exists would make all preformed destiny come to an end.
Not if you travel within God's channel.
I'm not going to be able to continue this conversation.
Why?
It gives me no pleasure to deny you the right to read one of the great writers of the 20th century, but alas, I have not yet been elected Queen of the Universe, so I must obey the rules, and so will you. So, anyone seen in this school reading this book will be suspended, but not to worry. Someone has already pre-ordered a dozen copies at the Sarasota Mall bookstore. In Mr. Green's absence, we will now be reading another classic, Watership Down by Richard Adams. Maybe you and Frank can read this one together.
Thank you.
grow out of our chest, solar plexus.
Just like she described in the book, the way they moved and they smelled, it's like they're workers. Assigned to each one of us, they're like liquid. You know, I followed it into my parents' bedroom.
What did you find?
Nothing. So we call them IMGs.
Infant memory generators.
Yeah, so the idea is that you buy these glasses for infant and they wear them at night when they sleep.
But inside the glasses are these slide photographs, and each photograph is of something peaceful or beautiful, whatever the parents want to put inside.
And what effect do you think that this would have on an infant?
Well, the thing is, nobody remembers their infancy, and anyone who says they do is lying, so we think this will help develop memory earlier in life.
Yeah.
And did you stop and think that maybe infants need darkness? That maybe darkness is part of their natural development?
No.
What if the parents, put in pictures of Satan? Like dead people, crap like that.
Is that what you'd show your kids?
Didn't your dad, stab your mom?
Get out. Wretched. Sorry about those guys.
Why are you wearing that stupid man suit?
Thank you.
clear-eyed. I call you Frank.
It is the name of my father. His father before me.
Frank? We're just gonna stop.
You should already. I want you to watch the movie screen. There's something I want to show you.
Now that was really something. Thank you, Sharita Chan, with Autumn Angel. And now the moment we've all been waiting for is here. It is my very distinct pleasure to introduce to you Emily Bates, Susie Bailey, Samantha Darko, Beth Farmer, and Joni James. They are Sparkle Motion.
long was I asleep for?
Look what the cat dragged in. How you doing, Donnie? Your sister was brokenhearted that you missed your big show once.
Yeah.
Hmm?
Crazy.
You're not crazy. I used to be crazy. But you're not crazy. Look. You're my only son.
I know I'm not the
best communicator, but whatever happens to you, be honest, tell the truth. Even if they do look at you funny, they will. But what you gotta understand, son, is that almost all of those people are full of shit. They're all part of this great big conspiracy. Bullshit. And they're scared of people like you. Because those bullshitters know that you're smart and all that. You know what you say to people like that? Fuck you.
The blaze was extinguished sometime after 8 o'clock last night. Now, firefighters discovered what has been referred to as a kiddie porn dungeon. Cunningham, who has become a recent celebrity for his books and motivational tapes, was arrested early
this morning
while golfing at the Sarasota Heights Country Club. Arson has not been ruled out as part of the cause of the fire.
Oh my God.
Now, a group of Cunning Vision employees...
Dad played golf with that guy.
...self-proclaimed fear survivor Linda Connie vehemently denied the alleged link to a child pornography publishing circuit. In a vicious statement, Connie attacked the middle sex worker department officials, claiming a bad
I'm sorry, Karen. This is a progressive school, but we don't feel the methods you've undertaken here are appropriate.
What exactly about my methods are inappropriate?
I am sorry that you have failed. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have another appointment. You can finish out the week.
What?
Good afternoon. It gives me great pleasure to announce that the Middlesex Ridge School dance team has been invited to perform on Ed McMahon's Star Search 88 in Los Angeles, California.
When the other rabbits hear of Fiverr's vision, do they believe him?
Why should we care?
Because the rabbits are us, Donnie.
Well, why should I mourn for a rabbit like it was human?
Are you saying that the death of one species is less tragic than another?
Of course. A rabbit's not like us. You know, it has no history books, no photographs, no knowledge of sorrow or regret. I mean, I'm sorry, Miss Bomber. I mean, don't get me wrong. You know, I like rabbits and all. They're cute and they're horny. And if you're cute and you're horny, then you're probably happy that you don't know who you are or why you're even alive. You know, you just want to have sex as many times as possible before you die. I mean, I just don't see the point in crying over a dead rabbit. You know, who never even feared death to begin with.
You're wrong. These rabbits can talk. They're the product of the author's imagination, and he cares for them, so we care for them. Otherwise, we've just missed the point.
But aren't we forgetting about the miracle of storytelling? The Deus Ex Machina, the God Machine? That's what saved the rabbits.
No, it was ridiculous. I'll call you back.
Rose. Kitty.
Rose, I'm sure that you're aware of the horrible allegations against Jim Cunningham.
I know, I saw it on TV, something about a kitty porn dungeon.
Oh, please, please, don't use those words. It's obviously some kind of conspiracy to destroy an innocent man. And I have taken it upon myself to spearhead the Jim Cunningham defense campaign. Rose, I have to appear at his arraignment tomorrow morning. And as you know, the girls are scheduled to leave for Los Angeles in the morning. Now, as their coach, I was the obvious choice to chaperone them on their trip.
But now you can't go.
Yes. Now, believe me, of all the other mothers, I would never dream of asking you, but none of the other mothers are available to go.
I don't know, Kitty. It's a bad weekend. Eddie's in New York.
Rose, I don't know if you realize what an opportunity this is for our daughters. This has been a dream of Samantha's and all of ours for a long time. I made her lead dancer. Sometimes I doubt your commitment to Sparkle Motion.
Elizabeth will be in charge. So drive you to therapy. And if you need anything, you promise me that you will call Dr. Thurman.
How's it feel to have a wacko for a son?
Feels wonderful. Taurus, there's tons of food in the fridge, and I left money on the kitchen table. And please do not pick it. Mom, go. You're going to miss your play.
There's nothing broken in my brain.
I know.
Hi, Donnie. It's Friday. Shouldn't you be off with your friends, scaring old people?
What's going on?
I don't know. That's a good question. Suffice to say, I'm no longer your English teacher. They fired me.
That's bullshit. You're the only good teacher here.
Thank you.
Let's sell our door.
This famous linguist once said that of all the phrases in the English language, of all the endless combinations of words in all of history, that cellar door is the most beautiful.
Cellar door.
Mm-hmm. talk about your past today. I want to talk about you and your parents.
They didn't buy me what I wanted for Christmas.
What did you want for Christmas that year?
Hungry, hungry hippos.
How did you feel being denied these hungry, hungry hippos?
Regret.
What else makes you feel regret?
That I did it again.
You did it again?
I fired my school and I burned down that pervert's house. I only have a few days left before they catch me.
Did Frank tell you to do these things?
I have to obey him. He saved my life. I have to obey him or I'll be left all alone. And then I won't be able to figure out what this is all about. I won't be able to know his master plan.
Do you mean God's master plan? Do you now believe in God?
I have the power to build a time machine.
How is that possible? How is time travel possible, Donnie?
Time's up, Frank said.
But when is this going to happen?
Soon.
Who is he going to kill? Who is he going to kill, Donnie?
I can see him right now!
Stop taking your medication. They're placebos, just pills made out of water.
Thank you.
Donnie. An atheist is someone who denies altogether the existence of God. You're an agnostic. An agnostic is someone who believes that there can be no proof of the existence of God, but does not deny the possibility that God exists.
Goodbye, Dr. Thurman.
Going to Harvard.
Hey, we should totally throw a party. I mean, Mom and Dad are gone, and like, it's Halloween carnival. We could totally get away with it.
Okay. It has to be small, right?
Dozen rolls of toilet.
I stole 4 beers from my dad.
We got a keg.
Keg beers for the pussies.
Call me as soon as you get this message. Thank you.
You okay?
Yeah, my mom's gone.
Yeah, good.
Was all messed up.
But you're okay. Did you call the cops?
Yeah, I said I should leave the house and that I should go to a safe place. I'm just so scared. I'd keep thinking something awful is happening and fucking stepdad. I know it. I guess people are just born with tragedy in their blood.
If you're there, please pick up. Oh, well. Good news. The girls, they got 3.5 stars, and they get to come back for the quarterfinals. Samantha was amazing. Anyway, we take red eye back to nine. And we ought to arrive.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll take the red eye back tonight. We should arrive around 8:30 in the morning. I hope everything's all right. I love you.
Dear Mr. Spiro, I reached the end of your book and there's so many things that I need to ask you. Sometimes I'm afraid of what you might tell me. Sometimes I'm afraid that you'll tell me that this is not a work of fiction. I can only hope that the answers will come to me in my sleep. I hope that when the world comes to an end, I can breathe a sigh of relief, because there will be so much to look forward to.
Tomorrow, and I find it kind of funny, I find it. By jet engine.
What was his name?
Donnie. Donnie Darko. I feel bad for his family.
Yeah.
Did you know him?